What's going on YouTube? R2R Moto here, and today we're going to be talking about the five things that I love about this bike right here, my 2015 FZ09. Let's roll the intro and get into the video. Alright, so right off the bat, you know what number one is. Everyone should know what number one is about the FZ09. The number one thing that I love about this bike is this engine. This engine is 847 cc's of pure joy. There's a reason that this bike is often referred to as a torque monster or a wheelie machine, and that's because it is. Now, unless you're me, because I can't wheelie, but that's neither here nor there, this video's not about me. But this bike pulls in every gear. No matter when you need the power, it is there for you. It can probably honestly wheelie in every gear. Like I said before though, I can't do that. But anyway, that's the first thing that I love about this bike. It's pretty self-explanatory. This engine is amazing. So let's go into the second thing that I like about this bike. So the second thing that I love about my FZ09 has to be the styling. So this bike, you can get this bike in multiple colors. You can get it anywhere between a silver tank like I have here. You can get a black tank. You can get a red tank. You can get a blue tank. You can get a charcoal tank. And I believe, yeah, you can get an orange tank. So that's like five different colorways that you can get depending on the model year that you go with. And then on top of that, you got the rims of the bike. So you got some with yellow rims, you got black rims, you got blue rims, and you even have red rims. And that's just stock. Like, you don't even have to color those. Like, a lot of people would pay to get like powder coated rims, but with those, you don't even have to worry about it. You get those, and it's just you, if that's your color scheme that you're looking for, you're set. And that's what I love, because this bike, although I'm wearing red gloves, this bike is silver and blue, and I really enjoy that color scheme. These were the gloves I started with on my bike before this, so that's why I have red gloves, regardless. So before I get into the third thing that I love about this bike, I'm going to tell you guys to go leave a comment down below with something that you'd like me to talk about in a future video. Give me some ideas of things to talk about. That way we can grow this channel, get some content out there that you guys want to see, and hit that subscribe button so in the future you can actually see when that video comes out. So the third thing that I love about my FZ09 has to be availability. Now, when I say availability, I mean two different things. One, the availability to purchase the bike, and two, the availability for mods for the bike. So this bike has been being produced since 2014, so 2014 up to 2019, and it's probably going to get a 2020 and forward because this bike's awesome. So you can get this bike new, 2019 or 2020, I don't know if they have announced 2020 model year for the FZ09, but this bike, I think currently, runs about $8,999 before tax and everything. So you're looking at probably $9,500 for a new version of this bike. Now that comes with ABS, it comes with traction control, comes with all the things that you could need to have this bike and keep it for a long period of time. And then if you're looking for something more of the used market, go with a cheaper route, you can get anywhere between the 2014 to 2016 range and get that bike for around $4,000 to like $7,000 with low miles on it. I got my bike used 2015, and I got it for about $5,500, and there was less than 1,000 miles on it. So there, you can definitely get these bikes for cheap. Even now, I've seen them online listed at about $5,000, $6,000 with like 1,000 or less miles on them. So that's amazing if you're trying to get one of these bikes. And then the second thing is that you have a basically wealth of mods for this bike. Now, as you can see here, I have the Woodcraft clip-ons on my bike. So that's one mod that you can do to it. You can do different lights, you can do different turn signals, you can do different exhausts. You got pretty much every manufacturer makes either a full system or slip-on for this exhaust and make it sound amazing. Now, I wish I could give you like a sound bite of that, but I don't have an exhaust on my bike because currently it's still stock. But every company has one. You got fender eliminators, which are standard pretty much for most bikes anyway. And basically any mod that you think that you would want to do to this bike, like a different seat or something like that, to make it your bike, to make it the comfort that you want or the look that you want, it has it. Now, you could say R2 Armoto, but everybody and their mother has an FZ09. And that might be true. That it actually kind of is true. A lot of people have this bike. One thing about this bike, it is not unique, but at the same time, think about this. How many people do you know have a Honda Grom or Z125? How many people do you know have a DRZ400 or WR250R? How many people do you know have some type of stunt bike or track bike, like an R6 or ZX6R? There's a reason that a lot of people buy those bikes, and that's because those bikes are, one, they're reliable, some are cheap, they're super fun, and they just give you a good time when you're riding. Like, there's a reason everyone has this bike, and it's because it's one of the most fun bikes that you can ride. All right, so the fourth thing, and this one's gonna be a little bit of a controversial one, because I'm gonna talk about it more in its stock configuration with its stock handlebars. So with the stock handlebars on this bike feels like a giant supermoto. It honestly, to me, is the perfect around the town bike. It's the perfect backroads bike. So then you could ask, why did I switch from the stock handlebars? And the one thing that this bike to me was lacking was the fact that when you're going highway speeds and going on the highway in general, just this bike, it turns you into a windsail. And with the stock handlebars, you sit in more of an upright position so that wind hits you in the chest and it feels like it's trying to like throw you back off the bike. Well, with these clip-ons, it gets you the option to be in a lower position, so that way when you're going those highway speeds, you can tuck in and it feels really good and doesn't hinder you when you're trying to ride at those faster speeds. But overall, if you're getting this bike, you don't have to switch to the clip-ons. This bike in its standard configuration with those stock handlebars, it feels really good. So with those four things being out of the way, it leads me to the fifth thing that I love about my FZ09. Now, this list could be longer. For example, I could talk about how I love the fact that this bike is a naked bike. So when you do your maintenance on it, you don't have to worry about taking off fairings, and it's just it makes the process so much smoother. But that aside and other minor things aside, the fifth thing that I love about my FZ09 has to be the modes. Now, the modes on this bike, I think they're still named the same, but they're different on the 2017 through 19 versions of the bike. But with this bike, you get three modes. You get A mode, you get standard mode, and you get B mode. So standard mode is going to be your normal riding mode. In most cases, and which I'm in now, standard mode, you're never going to really need to leave this mode. It does everything you need it to do. It pulls just like you would need it to. And it is really the all-around mode for this bike. Then you have B mode. B mode for the 2015 is basically rain mode. I think on the later model years, B mode is actually the really good like power mode. But B mode on this bike, at least, is basically rain mode. So it gives you a little bit of a delay when you pull the throttle. And basically, it's what I rode around in when I was first getting this bike, because this bike is a bit of a hooligan bike. And if you're not used to it, you pull that throttle, it can be scary at times. So riding in B mode is definitely the first thing I would do when you get this bike. But then it comes to the final mode, and the final mode is going to be A mode. Now, A mode, I lovingly name it, if you hit a pothole and you're not paying attention, you can probably wheelie the bike mode. And that being said, it's so when you pull it in standard mode, the throttle goes basically when you would expect it to go. When you pull it in B mode, it gives you a little bit of a delay, but eventually it goes. When you pull the throttle in A mode, though, it goes right away. Like, it goes right when you want it to. Oh my god. Like that bump, for example. If I hit that bump and I wasn't paying attention in A mode, I probably would have revved the throttle a little bit, and I would have been up on one wheel, probably. So with those five things being out of the way, the last thing I have to say is basically, if you are thinking about getting this bike, I say go for it. This bike is a bike that you can keep for life, and I think the positives of this bike definitely outweigh the negatives. So with that being said, if you like the content, if you like the content, hit that subscribe button for me. Hit the like button on this video if you enjoyed the video itself, and I'll see you guys in the future. Peace.